Hello students, here we are going to start a new chapter, that is Cities of India. And in your book you can find this chapter in page number 31. So my request to you all that whenever you are going to listen this video, please open your book page number 31. So what we are going to discuss in this video, basically we are going to discuss the topic like what are the major cities of India. See, there are so many major cities of India, like we have 12 largest and major cities like Mumbai, Bangalore, Delhi, Hyderabad, Ahmedabad, Chennai, Kolkata, Surat, Pune, Jaipur. We have all these kinds of cities, but we have four oldest and largest cities in India. Those are Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata and Chennai. And in this video we will cover Delhi, Mumbai very well and Kolkata in to some extent. Now let's come to the point of what is city. Like if I ask you that what is the basic difference between city and village, then what will be your answer? See, a city is a human settlement that is much larger than a village, or you can say a town. A city, thousands of people are crowded into a small area. Like you can see, a city is overcrowded area, like the population or the number of people live here or used to live here is much larger than a village. And so many other characteristics are there, like what, like most of the cities are very rich in factories or various offices. You can say the offices like technological offices or industrial offices, etc. Cities also have many tall buildings. Okay, like you can see here, simply you can see here that these are the crowd, like these are the population. Like you can see that in cities we have very well developed road, very well developed flyover. Flyovers are what? Flyovers are basically, in Bengali we call it Ural Pool. What we call? We call Ural Pool. So basically, what is the function of flyovers and where it can be seen? Can we see it in village? No, we cannot see flyovers in the village. We can see flyovers only in cities, that also the large cities. Okay, like in Kolkata, in Chennai, in Delhi's, like in New Delhi's, we have these well developed flyovers. Like what are the functions of these flyovers? If a road are very blocked by traffic, like you can see in this image, like here you can see much traffic is there. Okay, but if this road are consist of this flyover, then the short or the taxis or the short cars can go into the same direction by this flyover, whereas the buses or the lorries, they can go into the same direction by those road. So that the function of flyovers are basically to reduce the traffic. Okay, so now what are the other things in cities we can look? That cities have tall buildings, modern roads, a network of train. You can see that train can be local train, that train can be metros, and a network of bus. Like you can see these buses here, these are the metros here. And why do we need this? Because people need to go here and there, like go in different parts of the city, and for going to different parts of the cities they used to have this communication. Okay, now let's come to the point of the first city like we are going to discuss over here, that is New Delhi. See, India has many large cities. Now let us look at only four of the oldest and largest cities. Those are Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata and Chennai. The first we will look after this Delhi. Now see, if you see where Delhi is basically located in the political map. See, Delhi is located, okay, Delhi is basically located in the northern portion. You can see here the northern portion. This is the northern portion, this is the eastern portion, this is the southern portion and this is the western portion. So here in the northern portion it is located. Delhi is located in the northern portion. Okay, so now we have to remember another thing, that is Delhi is the capital of our country and it is located on the bank of Yamuna. Yamuna is very important river. Yamuna, it is a tributary of Ganga. Now that is not important. That important thing is Delhi is located on the bank of river Yamuna. Now Delhi is also called National Capital Territory of Delhi or NCT. Now question often come, what NCT means? So NCT means National Capital Territory. Okay, now who is known as territory, I mean national NCT? Delhi. Okay, now Delhi is one of the oldest cities of world, basically the world. Today it is also one of the largest cities in the world, because we have basically, I mean Delhi is basically consists of two cities. One is the old Delhi and another is the new Delhi. So you can see this is the old Delhi. These are the much crowded, the overcrowded lanes over here. And another thing is you can see that the monuments, basically you can see the monuments like Qutub Minar, like this, these are located in the old Delhi. See, old Delhi has narrow lanes, crowded markets. You can see here narrow lanes, you can see narrow crowded, overcrowded areas, whereas New Delhi has these multiplexes, cinema halls or cinema multiplex you can say, or multi-storied building, broader roads. You can see these are the broader roads, metro railways, etc. Okay, now another thing is the metro rail. Metro rail connects most of the parts of Delhi. It carries millions of people every day. As you know that Delhi is one of the largest cities in the world, like in whole world, you can see one of the largest cities is Delhi. So that means the population of Delhi is much higher, right? So that means every single day you can find millions of people going here and there, different parts of the city. So we need metro railway that can carry million of people every day with lesser amount of time. Another thing that you have to remember, that the government of India and all important offices are located here. The Prime Minister and President of India also live here, like the Indian Parliament, the Secretariat building, also located in India, I mean in Delhi. Now another thing, that is what are the major attraction and what are the climate of Delhi? See, it is very hot during the summer season. Like you can see, like this is the picture of summer season, this is the picture of summer season, and further this is the picture of winter season. So it is very hot in summer season and very cold in winter season, that you have to remember. Another thing that you have to remember from this topic, that what are the major languages? See, the major languages are basically Hindi, Punjabi, English, but the main official language you can say that English and Hindi. Now, one of the most important thing that you have to remember that the beautiful monuments and what are the major attractions of Delhi. See, you can see Qutub Minar, like this is the 73 meters. Qutub Minar is one of the tallest minars in India, and it is it was built almost like thousands or 1200 years ago. Like this is a beautiful picture of Qutub Minar taken by a beautiful photographer. Now another thing you have to remember that what are another monuments, like other than Qutub Minar, you have to remember the name of India Gate, the name of Rashtrapati Bhavan, Purana Kila. Another one is the Humayun's Tomb, Lotus Temple. These are the famous monuments. Okay. Another thing that you have to remember that this is the famous Delhi street foods. Like we all like street foods. We all like in Kolkata you can find so many street foods. Like in Delhi also you can find so many street foods, and there also you can have different kinds of chaats, chole bhature, golgappa. These are the you have to remember. Okay. Another thing, now let's come to the point of Mumbai. Now see, if you see the location of Mumbai, this is the western coast. This is the western coast. So it is located on the western coast of India by the Arabian Sea. You can see this is the Arabian Sea. Okay. Let me just zoom out this place. You can see here you can see Arabian Sea, here you can see Arabian Sea, and in this coast, like in the western coast, it is located, and it is the capital of the state Maharashtra. Like you can see, this is the Maharashtra. let me point it out. This is the boundaries of Maharashtra, and this is Mumbai. Okay. Now you need to remember that what are the important features of Mumbai, like what languages are said, and Mumbai is also known as Bombay, and it is one of the major or important port city. Now what is port? A port is a place where ships load and unload goods and passengers. Okay, like I will show you the picture of a port. And what are the main languages are spoken here? Like Marathi, Gujarati, very common, and Hindi and English. So in which state Mumbai is located? Maharashtra, and it is the capital of Maharashtra. You have to remember that. And on which coast it is located? It is coast, western coast. This is western coast, and it is located western coast by Arabian Sea. Okay, so like next thing you have to remember that what is the climate, like what is the pattern of the climate. See, Mumbai is a very pleasant during whole season. Okay, like basically in winter it is not very very cold in winter. It is like pleasant, mostly pleasant in winter, and it is warm and humid in the summer. But in the rainy season it rains heavily. Like you can see here, like all the stagnant waters are here. And besides this, so what are the important points regarding climate of Mumbai? Like it is warmer, humid in summer, pleasant in winter, but it rains very heavily during the rainy season. And it is very famous. Mumbai is very famous for its monsoon, right? Next you need to remember that Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus Railway, it is very important to remember, because Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus Railway Station was designed by the British architect and it was built more than 120 years ago. Okay, so what we learned before in the previous slides, like in Delhi, what we learned, like Qutub Minar was built almost like thousands years ago by Mughal emperors. Not by you Mughal emperors, I'm very sorry, not by Mughal emperors, before the Mughal emperors it was built. Okay, next you need to remember that this Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus Railway, it is one of the most important British architect and it was built 120 years ago. Another attraction of Mumbai is Elephanta Cave. Like this is the Elephanta Cave, Siddhivinayak Temple, Haji Ali Darga, Gateway of India, Bombay High Court, Wankhede Stadium. We have so many attractions of Mumbai. So you can settle a trip after COVID-19 into the Mumbai. Next, you need to remember that what are the famous beaches of Mumbai and what are the main mode of transport. See, the main mode of transport in the city of Mumbai is the network of local trains. This is not so important because local trains are important and you can find local trains over here and there, but in Mumbai it is a very overcrowded local trains. Like it is not like Howrah and Sialdah local trains, it is very crowded. Several famous beaches we have in Mumbai, like we have Chowpatty, we have Juhu. This is Juhu, this is Aksha Beach, this is Chowpatty Beach. We have so many famous beaches in Mumbai. And another thing, this is port. I have told you that this is port, like this is the port of Mumbai. This is port of Mumbai. You can see that like ships are here. And this is a famous characteristics of Mumbai, that this is the one of the port cities. Okay, because so what I told about the port, like a port is a place where cities where basically the ships load and unload goods or passenger. Okay, so you can see this is the port of Mumbai. And another thing you need to remember that about the main festival of Mumbai is Ganesh Chaturthi. You can see that so many crowd you can see, and the features of Ganesh Chaturthi is like we who are live in Kolkata, we are very fond of Durga Puja, right? Our main festivals is Durga Puja. Similarly, their main festival is basically the Ganesh Chaturthi. So this question often come, and this another question come, that is about the Chhatrapati Shivaji, and this is built by British. I'm telling you, and how many years ago? 120 years ago. Okay, now let's come to the point of Kolkata. Now it is the capital of West Bengal. You can see this is West Bengal. This is West Bengal. Now let me zoom this slide. You can have idea. See. This is West Bengal, and like in the downside of the West Bengal, we have located Kolkata. Okay. Now the city was created by the British more than 200 years ago. Now since then it has grown to become one of the largest and most important cities. Okay, now Kolkata is also an important port. Kolkata is one of the oldest ports in the India, and it is located on the bank of river Hooghly. Okay, you can see this is Hooghly river. Like let me point this out. This you can see this river over here. This is the Hooghly river. Okay. This you need to remember. Now another thing you need to remember, that what are the main languages spoken, and on which bank. I have already told you that on which bank it is located, on the river Hooghly river, not Ganga, okay, not Ganga, Hooghly river, okay. And now here you need to remember one short story regarding Kolkata, that British had initially made Kolkata, then they told us like Calcutta, not Kolkata, and it was the capital of India. Like now India's capital is Delhi, but on that time India's capital was Calcutta, and it remained so till like 1911. But after that, the Britishers shifted the capital to the Delhi. So the Calcutta was first capital of India. That you need to remember. Another thing you need to remember, that what are the main festivals? Main festivals basically Durga Puja, that we all know, and what is the popular sweet of Bengal? Popular sweet of Bengal is basically Rasgulla. We all love Rasgulla, right? We all love Rasgulla. You can see these are white Rasgullas, these are Mishti Doi, these are like Bhat, rice. These are the, these are the Ilish March, and this is essence of Kolkata, okay. And another thing you need to remember, that what are the main features, like what are the main monuments, or what are the main what are the main buildings, like Victoria Memorial. We have, this is the Victoria Memorial, we have important one, let me show you. Yes, this is Victoria Memorial, this is Howrah Bridge, Kolkata High Court, Cathedral Church. This is one of the another feature of Victoria Memorial. Tram. Kolkata is only Indian city where you still get to see the tram. A tram is a bus like vehicle which runs on the railway track. Can you imagine, like a bus like vehicle that runs on a railway track on the road? So these are important features of Kolkata, and the main languages are told basically Bengali and English. No other languages but Bengali and English. So this is all about Kolkata, Delhi and Mumbai. And what are the important question regarding these topics? Like Delhi is located on the bank of what? On the bank of Yamuna. Kolkata is located on the bank of what? On the bank of river, what I told? Hooghly. Dash is the most famous festival of Mumbai. I have told you that is the what is the main festival of Mumbai? Ganesh Chaturthi. State one difference between Old Delhi and New Delhi. I have already told you that Old Delhi has colorful crowded lanes, colorful crowded markets, but New Delhi are the newer part of the city, and it has broader roads, many multi-storied buildings, etc. So how will you define a city? You tell me that city is a human settlement that is much larger than village, or you can say town. Like in a city you can see thousands of people crowded into a small area. Okay, Gateway of India, where it is located? Gateway of India located in Mumbai. So all of this you need to remember from these things. So thank you so much. Try to solve another question, like make your question and solve you, and this question, like this six question, you solve it. Like I am telling you these questions, like these answers I am telling you, but try to solve yourself also. Thank you so much.